Hi, I'm Vishal Rain. In this video tutorial, I'll be discussing about advanced IK twist control in IK spline handle. So let's get started. So I would like to create a simple model with a box here. So you could see I've just got a cube with some 6 units of height here with 6 subdivisions in it. Nothing great about this model. The idea is only to understand the twist control here. So for this model I'd create joints. The joint's primary axis is X and secondary axis is Y, which is very default way of creating the joints here. I'll control the radius of this joints here. Let me add this geometry into a layer. So you could see I've got this joint chain and a geometry. So let me select this joint and the geometry and apply the skinning. So I'm using smooth bind here with the default settings. So I should get the geometry following the joints. Fine. So this up to this it's very basic general. So what we do is now create IK spline handle. So for IK spline handle I need a spline, so I'm going to create a curve with EP curve tool. The curve degree should be one linear curve. Using point snap I've created a curve. Let me call this as spline curve. Now if you generally apply this IK spline handle, so there is an option called auto create curve. This option is on, it means when I create IK spline handle on the joint chain, a curve is created automatically with the number of spans you have specified here. But if I generally switch it off, the tool asks for IK spline curve after you applied on the joint chain. Like I'm selecting the joint, root joint, then the tail joint. Now if you could see, it's asking for the curve to pick it as a handle. You could see here. Now you've got this IK spline handle created. Let me open the attribute editor and also just see the geometry. Here in IK solver you have got this twist control which generally twists the joint chain along the root joint till end joint. The twist will be the amount you have specified here. But if I just get into the IK spring advanced twist controls, you have some enable twist controls. So twist controls will be at advanced level here. That means you're generally using a curve to control it. So let me create some curve. It's not about curve. You can take any object generally. So as we use joint chain and all in rigging, and for controls we use curves. So I'm taking a circle. So let me select these two controls and delete its construction history and apply freeze transformations. So let me call, as the twist goes from root to the tail joint, so I'm selecting this control and naming this as control 1 and this one as control 2. So I'm going to use this two controls to control the twist of the curve. So when I select the curve and generally twist it, I should get the twist applied onto the total joint chain. Before getting into that, let me select the joint chain and go to display, transform display, local rotation axis. You could see here Y axis facing this side, Z axis is facing this side throughout the joint chain. And how about the local rotation axis of the curves? Display, transform display, local rotation axis. The local rotation axis is very much aligned to the world space here. So X is this side and Z is this side. So let me bring the joints. Sorry, I'm in isolate mode. Open the attribute editor and just enable the twist controls. It would be good if I even enable or make the joints visible here. Sorry, geometry visible here. Yeah, fine. So in world app type, I'll be using object rotation app. You have got positive Y. Now this positive Y is generally nothing but the joint's Y axis to be faced to a specific direction. So are you asking the joints Y to be aligned with something, or you're asking Z to be aligned to something you say? So if I generally choose positive Y right now, let's see what we can generally do here. So as I said, first control and second control. First control goes into world app object, which I'm going to call as control 1, and this one is control 2. So these two controls will control the twist of the joint. So if you could see, I'm saying that the controls x-axis is a guideline to the joints. These joints Y will try to align with it. So let's have a look. So I'm saying world app vector x-axis, up vector 2 x-axis. So controls x is making the joints Y to align. You could see which axis of the joint chain you want to align with. I said positive Y. Generally don't be confused with up axis, generally think this way. So I'm just saying positive Y will be aligned with what? It will be aligned with the controls x-axis. How did I tell that? I tell that with the name of the object, control 1. Control 1's x-axis is the vector to which the joints vector will be aligned. So joints vector, in the sense, which axis will align with the controls x? I said it's y. So you could see controls x is this side and y is this side, the same side in fact. And if I generally change my positive y to negative y, so controls x is this side, negative y is also that side. And I said positive z, so z will try to align with the controls x. So that is what this setting is about. Now what we achieve out of it? Now you could see when I select a control and twist it, as when I twist it, the control, its x-axis will generally get oriented. And joint, the last joints y will try to orient with it. Now how about the rest of the joints? Let me show you what happens to this control. When I start twisting this, in which direction the x-axis will face, in that direction the joints y will face. So this first joint and the last joint twist are aligned with the respective controls. The in between joints will be a interpolated orientation, will be aligned in that manner. So this will give you extra level of control. Why is that necessary to do this? In when you are using IK spline handle in rigging human spine or spinal cord, we generally make use of this FKA rigging, and we generally lack twist controls in it, and it generally helps you not only in generally FKA rigs. When you rotate X or when you rotate Z, you get the orientation, but you don't get the twist controls in it. So this control will give you that extra little control of twist in your spinal cord rig of any character you do. So this rig can even used in some props, it can be used in vehicles, anywhere you want where you are expecting twist controls. The twist should be completely in the animator's hand, then this is a perfect choice. Hope you like this video. Thank you very much.